How does quarantine affect memory? During Corona's birth, many people became involved in daily life and isolated. According to the findings, these conditions are not very good for our memory. If you find it difficult to remember to email someone during quarantine, or you do not remember a word, or forget to buy milk, you are not alone. Of course, the data is not complete and it is too early to compare memory skills before and after the birth of COVID-19, but according to the Alzheimer's Association, half of those who reported the memory loss to those around them reported it during quarantine. Subscribe our YouTube channel to watch the rest of this video and more. Limitations of social distancing and in some cases a ban on visiting for several months can affect a person's memory. Research has begun at the University of California on how quarantine affects people's memory. According to reports, even some people with a strong memory have memory problems that are reminiscent of things like buying a movie ticket about 20 years ago. Of course, there are different types of memory, and forgetting the shopping list is different from forgetting the names of people or, for example, the work done in the past few days. But new research has looked at the effect of a closed environment on memory. The most obvious criterion is isolation or isolated living. Lack of social contact can have a negative effect on the brain, and this effect is more severe in people who struggle with memory problems. Of course, not all people feel lonely during that, and according to some studies, the severity of loneliness becomes uniform over time. Even if you do not feel lonely, you will still be in contact with fewer people than usual, and you will miss conversations at work or conversations with other people and the opportunity to retell your stories. By repeating stories, you can strengthen your memory, but given the lack of social relationships, poor memory function is not uncommon. With the cancellation of holidays, the postponement of weddings, the cancellation of concerts and sports events without spectators, the opportunity for conversation is reduced. Online social relationships can counteract the effects of isolation, but usually on social platforms you have to define a story that is worth telling, and you can rarely talk about common issues. However, the main problem is not just the lack of social relationships, and many people express their anxiety during quarantine. University College London began research into how British people felt during Corona's birth. Although the level of anxiety peaked at the beginning of the quarantine period and then gradually decreased, the average level of anxiety was still higher than usual. Anxiety was higher among young people, people living alone or with children, low-income people, and urban dwellers. According to the British National Statistics Office, the rate of depression has doubled during the Corona world, and both anxiety and depression affect memory. Concerns take up memory, as a result, there is less capacity to memorize shopping lists or other tasks. Needless to say, the lack of clues to help memory complicates the situation. If you work outside the home, time points for memory coordination are created by changing path and interruptions. But when you work from home, each online session will be similar to the previous one, because you usually sit in the same position and in front of the same screen, fewer tags are created in memory to separate events. Catherine Lowdy, a professor of neuroscience at the university, says, "Trying to recall what happened while there is little difference between the days is like trying to play the piano when there are no black buttons on the piano. In addition to the fact that the days merge with each other, the daily tasks are the same. At the office, you may walk through a room you previously had a meeting in and suddenly remember to send an email to someone. However, there is no clue at home to help remind people of different tasks. because all parts of memory are labeled as if sitting in front of a computer. In the workplace, you remember exactly where your conversation is, and thus you find a clue to remember things. In addition, there is the problem of fatigue. Zoom sessions are tedious and things get harder when home and holidays are cancelled. Anxiety about giving birth can also disrupt sleep. As a result, despite the combination of fatigue, anxiety, lack of clues, and less social interaction, memory impairment is not uncommon. Lowdy believes that another criterion is effective: spending time in different geographical locations. As soon as you leave the house, pay attention to your surroundings. Regardless of whether your path passes through the forest or around the city, at these times an area of the brain called the hippocampus is activated. You need to engage your hippocampus to learn new information. According to a neuroscientist at University in Canada, if people spend more time in an enclosed environment, their use of hippocampus decreases with age. Even drivers who rely on automatic navigation systems and satellites to find their way have poorer spatial memory, which is highly dependent on the hippocampus. If you spend a lot of time at home due to corona birth, you may have missed the routine stimulus. The good news is that all of these problems can be solved. Walking, especially on unfamiliar streets, increases the attention of your brain. Even the type of movement makes a difference. Do you sit at a table for each session? If you make a phone call, you can walk while talking. Try to differentiate your days of the week from the days of the weekend so that these days do not merge with each other. This way, you can understand the time difference. Lowdy recommends increasing diversity in life, which includes creative thinking. She suggests that if you cannot get out of the house, start a whole new and different activity at home and then tell someone about it, so you can memorize the details better. You can write down even your daily memories. Maybe something interesting and different will not happen, but when you get back to it one day, it will be fascinating. By doing this, you can help your memory during the work. If you forget your tasks, make a list of them and set an alarm on your smartphone for them. You can also use your imagination. If you want to remember to buy milk, bread, and eggs, you can imagine yourself in front of the essential shelves of a real store. When you get there, this shopping trip will be remembered again in your mind, and you will remember your shopping list.